Welcome everybody. In the previous two videos, we talked about the UI side of Zoho for Everyone, how to get used to this new UI, which I think it will save you some time getting used to it if you will watch this video. We also talked about the problems that's coming with those views. And this is also something that I recommend you to see because it can introduce new problems to your organization. In this video, we are going to talk about the new things that will come with Zoho for Everyone. There will be two new big things in this edition. One will be the ability to create team modules, and the other one will be to create team spaces, and those will be the team spaces. In the previous version, those were the tabs, the group tabs. And now they change it to have more functionality, and it's also named team spaces. We are going to start with the team spaces. First of all, how to create a team space, and then how to create a module using the Teams modules, which is something else. If you will click here, you will see that you have different team spaces. And if I click on, let's say, sales, you can see that I can have access now only to few modules, not all of them. And the idea is that every group in the company will have access to what they need to see versus everything. And we see that it's really the way. Also, when we use canvas views, we see that people tend to use them more than just regular views because we're able to eliminate the noise and let people concentrate only on what they need to work. Let's create a new team space, and that will be for the legal department. And we'll click on new team space. First of all, you will be able to upload some kind of an icon to it, or you can just click on one of those icons. And let's give a name to this department, and that will be legal. Next, we need to select modules that they can see. Let's take the main three. So we'll take, let's say, the leads, we'll take the contacts, accounts. I think here it says opportunities. Okay, so we'll have those four modules. You can enable or disable the ability to have reports and dashboards for this specific new team space. And you can assign different people to it. So in my case, I will not have the entire company. I will have only Jim and Jeff. Those are the two that will be part of this team space. And we'll click on save. So right now you can see here that a new team space was created named Legal. And when your employees will click on it, they will be able to see only a few modules versus many. And that's, I think it's already a good start. The next thing that you can do it's to go to the plus button and create a team module. The team module will be a specific module for a specific group, which means that this module will not be shown to the entire organization like it was before. And this is the one before the previous version, you were only able to create a module for the entire company, entire organization. Right now, you can create modules that are very much specific for specific teams. Let's assume that you will have a need to create agreements, and only the legal team is supposed to see those modules. Not everybody is supposed to see them. So there will be something that's happening in the background. So let's assume a deal goes to close one, and then there will be automatically a request to the legal department to create those agreements. And this is what we're going to do now, creating a new module, and that will be only for the legal department. When I click on next, you will see that you have a bunch of templates that you can choose from. Zoho are going a lot and more with the direction of creating templates, so it will be easy for you to click and get something done fast. But all those are defeating the purpose of adding a CRM. Having a CRM that is not personalized for your needs, it's exactly the same as using some kind of Excel or something like that. There need to be every button, every module, every functionality, every automation counts, and they need to be exactly for your needs. Otherwise, it's a waste of time. In order to speed things up, I will just click on one of those modules. You will see that this module is going to be created with a bunch of fields that are pre-populated for me. You can or create new fields for this module, or you can edit them yourself, okay? Now, one thing that I do like about this, the team module, you're able to define permissions per field once you're creating them. In the old version, the previous version, you could do most of those. You didn't have the requester, for example, which is a new ability, but you had to go to many steps before you could do those actions. Here, while I'm creating, I'm able to define, for example, if a requester can see the case number, or maybe read only, so they can just see it, but they cannot do anything, or they can see and also change it. So this is a nice ability. Whenever I'm clicking on create, the module will be created and it will be added to the left side as a new module for this specific department. And you can see it here. The behavior is exactly the same like any other module. You can click on create, you can create the different records, and you will see them exactly the same way that you will see any other module, okay? But the idea is that now you have the ability to create those specific modules for a specific group, and you're able to assign specific permissions. There is one more thing that I want to show you, and that's my request. Every time that someone with a role as a requester, when they want to see a record, they will be able to request to see a record. It will show here, and then you can approve or deny. And if you approve, only then they can see it. So a requester role will not see anything unless the record that they wanted to see were approved by someone higher in the food chain. That's really all the new things that I can think of with this version. Carol, do you have anything else in mind with this new version?
I think that covers everything.
Okay, very good. So again, just to summarize those last three videos. Step number one, you need your team to get used to this view before you go live. Step number two, you need to make sure that the permissions and the roles are correctly adjusted for this specific view. Otherwise, people can damage your system. And third thing, it's optional, it's to take action on what I showed you in this video. Get used to the team modules, get used to the new permission system, but this is for sure optional. The bare minimum is for your team to get used to how to use the new UI and fix your permission system. Super critical. That's it. So thank you very much for being with us for the last three sessions. We'll continue to provide you interesting and important materials as we go.